My name is Dr. Gareth Morgan. I'm the head of interventional congenital cardiology on campus here. That means I cover children's cardiac catheterizations and adults with congenital heart disease at both the Children's Hospital and University. So as a team, we catheterize patients from fetal life right the way through to tiny babies and on up to adults with congenital heart disease at any age. So the big thing that's new about PDA closure for small infants at the moment is the FDA approval of the Abbott Piccolo device, also known as the AD02AS, to give it its technical title. And this has been a huge amount of effort by both Abbott, who've developed this device, and also many clinicians around the world, and particularly based in the USA, who've worked so hard to bring this device to market over the last several years. What it is a tiny device made of the metal alloy nitinol that allows us specifically and with FDA approval to percutaneously, by a catheter route, close the ductus arteriosus in babies as small as 600 or 700 grams. Previously, there have been devices that many of us have used, but this is the first time in the US that there's been a specific FDA approved device for this indication. And that's created a lot of confidence and huge change in attitude amongst interventional cardiologists and neonatologists around the country and indeed around the world. Data and evidence around PDA closure for tiny babies has fluctuated a lot over the last 20 or 30 years. So we've never really been at a point where it's been extremely clear cut that babies with significant ductus arteriosus benefit from having the duct closed in the neonatal period. And a lot of that has been due to the fact that we haven't had tailor-made equipment for tiny babies, or that the other method for closing the duct has been surgically through a thoracotomy. Both with equipment that's not designed for small babies and with surgery through the chest, the risks and the morbidity are very tangible. And that's been something that we as interventional cardiologists have been aware of, but also the neonatologists, who are the patients who are responsible, or the doctors who are responsible for these patients' care, they've been really concerned about this. Now that we've come up with something that's designed specifically for tiny babies to close the duct, I think that's really renewed everybody's enthusiasm and confidence that closing the duct in small babies is the right thing to do. It hasn't been clear that the benefit towards their lung disease and their overall development has overridden the risks of the procedure before, but now with this specific device, I think that might be much more tangible and obvious. So we're very fortunate because of previous colleagues that have worked here, Professor Neil Wilson, who was in my post before me, and the team that I work with. We've been trusted by the community and by Abbott to be the only hospital in the area that has got access to this device for these tiny babies. I think because of work that I did in Europe and that, again, Professor Neil Wilson did, it means that we've been doing this procedure actually for many years, and now we've just been able to bring it to the local community. So at the moment in Colorado, we're the only hospital that can provide this treatment. And indeed, outside Colorado, throughout many states, this is not available. So it is exciting for us to be, as a large referral hospital, to be somewhere that these babies can be referred to, that we can provide this service throughout this state and neighboring states. So from our point of view, practically, there isn't really a limitation on how young the baby can be before we do this. But the neonatologists will know that they probably want to spend a period of time, normally in days or a couple of weeks, to determine whether or not the right thing is to close the duct. So there's many, many other things happen in the first few days after birth that make this decision a lot more tenuous. The decision tends to become a lot more obvious that we need to close the duct after a week or so has passed. And depending on obviously how the birth has gone and what's happening in the postpartum period, we do encourage that the mum comes with the baby and spends time here during the baby's recovery. and we can obviously facilitate that. And it's usually long enough after birth that that's doable. So once a referring group are aware that we have this capability, and if they decide that for the baby they're looking after, the right thing is to close the Ductus Arteriosus, then after contacting with us and setting up transport and a referral, then the baby would need to be transferred here. After a very brief assessment, which might be less than 24 hours, we would be able to go ahead, bring the baby to our cath lab. And through quite a quick procedure, on average around 45 minutes, we should be able to close the Ductus Arteriosus, have the baby recover in our neonatal intensive care unit, and then straight away arrange for transport back to the unit that's caring for them, obviously depending on the baby's stability. But ideally, we'd be trying to turn things around and have the baby back to the referring unit within a couple of days of referral. So coming this way, the referring neonatologist would contact me or one of my colleagues, discuss the clinical scenario with the patient, all their different characteristics. We would agree that it was the right thing to do to refer the patient and transfer the patient here. And then once they arrive here, they would come to the neonatal department. The neonatologist here would stabilize things and prepare so that everything's ready for them to go to the cath lab. The cardiac cath lab here is just one floor down from the neonatal unit in the same building, and the patient would be brought down, would be managed by our specific cardiac anesthesiologists, and then we would do the procedure to close the duct. They'd be transferred back to the neonatal unit immediately after the procedure, and then once we define that everything's stable, the procedure's gone well, and there haven't been any complications, then the patient would be transferred back to their home unit for basically continued care of their lung disease or other neonatal problems that are ongoing. So what we want to make sure is that we're not taking over the care of these patients. The neonatal care of these patients still lies with their referring neonatologists. We would provide some input into what monitoring we would like to keep an eye on the Ductus Arteriosus and the surrounding structures after it's been occluded. So we would recommend that they would have echocardiography, which is usually available at most neonatal units, to check on the vessels around the duct that we've closed off, x-ray monitoring and clinical monitoring. So the actual follow-up after the device is placed is very, very much within the remit of the referring neonatal team. From our point of view, we are always on hand to provide advice or interact with the neonatal team if they have questions about the procedure we've done, the device, what the consequences might be. But ideally, the best thing would be the baby gets better and the neonatal team look after the other neonatal problems, and we actually don't have to be involved after that. But the key thing is we always offer to be there to provide support, advice, and counselling if there's any questions about the procedure or the follow-up afterwards. So this is a relatively new procedure from the point of view of using this new device. At present, we are on average in babies less than 2 kilograms doing one or two of these procedures a month. Now that may not seem like an awful lot, but actually compared to the national average and also compared to what we were doing before the new device was available, that's really quite significant. And I think it's testament to the amount of effort that we've put in that actually we are one of the centers from which proctors go out and teach this procedure to other departments around the country. And again, I'm lucky that Abbott have entrusted me to do that with other centres, so that in cardiology departments like ours around the country, we can make sure that the education and experience of those interventional cardiologists is as good as possible. And I don't think they'd ask us to do that if industry didn't have confidence that this was one of the places that does this best. I think there's two separate sets of concerns. So from a physician point of view, we need to understand what the major risks are for these tiny patients. In truth, the actual period of time during the procedure is maybe not the most critical point. Obviously, the decision making during the procedure is hugely important, but an important thing is ensuring that the patient is otherwise kept well. So all the other delicate parts of the neonatal physiology need to be attended to while we focus on closing the duct. So the experience of our neonatologists, the experience of our cardiac anesthesiologists become really paramount to keeping the rest of the baby safe while we do this procedure. So from our point of view, things like temperature control, avoidance of sepsis, brief procedure, ensuring the patient is away from the neonatal unit for the shortest possible period of time, ensuring their ventilation can be exquisitely carefully managed because of the differences in ventilation requirements for tiny babies rather than other children. All these things actually become as important or maybe more important than the procedure itself. The procedure itself, a lot of the important hinge points are based on the decision about what type and what size of device to place in the tiny baby. And again, that's something that comes with experience and a knowledge of the anatomy of these tiny babies' vessels. For the families, I think the concerns maybe aren't completely aligned with this. So the concerns of the family of the fact that we're putting catheters through the tiny vessels they have, and they're undergoing a procedure that may be considered to be quite new. And when we counsel these families, that becomes very important. We've been doing procedures like this on very small babies for a very long time. We've previously been doing these procedures with devices that were not specifically designed. So therefore, I would say that everything's actually getting safer because we're still doing the same procedures we've done with more experience and with devices and equipment that has been specifically designed for tiny babies. So much of what we do in pediatric and congenital cardiology is based on equipment that's derived from adult practice that we have to make do and use in small babies and children. And thankfully, we're now getting to a point where equipment and devices is being specifically designed for the uses that we need. So for me, talking to families, I can be quite positively reassuring to them that every day we do this and every year we do this, we're getting safer and safer and better because of the equipment and because of the experience we have. So as an interventional cardiologist, I am not a neonatologist. Although I have a huge interest in trying to improve the care that we give tiny babies and improve the techniques that we have for managing tiny babies with congenital heart disease, the decision making and the overall care plan for these babies lies with the neonatal team. I think it's really important that a neonatologist who's considering these sort of procedures for the babies they are responsible for realize that they need to be confident in the data and they need to make the decision about whether they think this is the right thing to do for those babies. Once they've done that and they contact us, then what we can do is provide the best environment and the safest hands to do the procedures. The neonatology team have the experience and the expertise and need to be in control of what happens to the babies that they're looking after. We are really there to provide the service to try and move the baby's care forward and hopefully facilitate earlier recovery from the neonatal problems they've got. From my point of view, we would be doing a disservice to the children if we don't provide good communication with the neonatal team, we don't keep them in the loop, we don't explain fully everything that's happened during the patient's time here, but really key that we make sure and facilitate the fact that the referring neonatologist is still in overall control of the patient's care. And I think if we ever got away from that, that would be very sad. So we're all pushing very hard to make sure that maintains our standard.